So I haven't done it in a while, but today we're gonna test my one rep max squat. And my squat, I just try to do more of an Olympic style squat. So Olympic style squat means getting ass to grass. So everybody has but when it comes to getting ass to grass, you either could have the ability to do so or you don't, just based on femur structure and how it sits in the hip socket. So, but for me, I like getting low. I like getting that deep because I know that more than just my quads are firing, it's hamstrings, glutes, you know. And so I'm excited to test for my one rep max squat. I'm going to vlog it. I'm going to vlog my warm up, vlog how I've been prepared for that. And yeah, so I like to do this type of testing because it shows me where I'm at. And then with me filming, it's going to show me what I need to work on. Because when your body goes through a lot of stress, you know, a lot of stress on the body, and the body starts showing things that you don't see when there's not a ton of stress, meaning load on the body. So when there's a ton of load, you know, intensity is up, we tend to see a little bit more with what's weak. So like the squat is a great way. It's the mother lift, the lower body. It's a great way to kind of seeing where you are when you are going underneath a lot of load. And yeah, I want to see where I'm at, and I'm curious to see what I'll hit today. I feel good, that's why I'm gonna test. And it's my fourth week of this program, so yeah, we're gonna test that. Hold on, there's a cop. I don't want him to see, even though I have tints in my car, I don't want him to see that I have my phone in my hand. But I'm almost to the gym, my work. And yeah, we're gonna vlog this thing. We're gonna have fun, I'm gonna have fun, and I want to see how I would take it through, how I would take a client through this. I'm gonna take myself through, just like I take my clients through it. And I'm gonna show, I've been wanting to do this, I'm gonna show a couple of my clients new like personal records with their squad, you know, their PRs. So I'm very happy with all of them, and the ones that I've had done this so far, they feel really good about it. And yeah, you're gonna see some good squat, good numbers here. You'll see somebody squat that squats way more than me. He's a bigger dude, but I'm super happy about how deep he gets. And yeah, that's very exciting. But yeah, just pulling up to the gym now, and we're gonna, you know, get this warm up ready. Get the warm up. Get the, you know, my electrolytes and my aminos in, and yeah, we're gonna get after this. All right, quick tip. So when you're squatting and you're setting up, you want the bar to be about chest high. So when you do have a lot of load on the bar, you're not tiptoeing, trying to rack it. So yeah, chest high. It's all right, just get under there, set up, make sure your grip is always same width apart, right? And then you could either get underneath the bar 2 foot, well, staggered stance like this, or 2 feet like this. Make sure you squeeze your back, activate your lats, focus on a good brace. So inhale through your belly, hold that air in there, squeeze like you're going underwater. Okay, about to warm up. We're gonna hit 6 reps, 5 reps, 4 reps, 3 reps, 2 reps, 1, and then I'm gonna go until I feel like I'm gonna fail or that I failed, something like that. So again, we're gonna start with like 135 on the bar and then just hit that for 6 reps and then just slowly increase weight and drop my reps. And what I'm doing is just trying to feel how I feel during the squat and just trying to feel my body out before I put a lot of load on it. Because if I don't feel right and things are feeling off, maybe something's bugging me with my legs, I might not do it because I don't feel 100%. So just for this purpose, because I want to make sure when I hit my one rep max, I'm feeling freaking good. I'm feeling like, all right, weight's moving pretty damn good today. I feel good. My body feels freaking good. So let's go right into this. I'm going to start with 135 for 6. All right, I got to haul ass. Because I got Comcast coming at my house at 10, setting up Wi-Fi, because hopefully me and Rachel are getting in the house this weekend, right in time for New Year's. Start that new year off right. Yes. Feeling freaking good. I felt really good. My mobility has gotten a shit ton better. So whatever I'm doing, it's working. I know what I'm doing, but that's not for another video. Gonna hit 5 reps here. Focus on a good brace, keeping my back, my lats tight, meaning activated. Alright, lighting's pissed right now, so we're about to hit 185 for 4. Moving weight pretty good, feeling really good. Mobility just feels the best I've ever had with my squat. And yeah, just very happy about how I'm feeling. And as you can see, I'm not just going from 135 to 185 to 225. Like, I'm slowly kind of building up to that heavier weight because I got a lot of sets to get to that one rep max. So again, we're going to hit 4 here. And then 3, and then 2, and then 1. As I drop reps, again, I'm increasing weight. I'm just trying to feel how my body out. So I don't want to increase weight too much, right? It's just getting it slowly acclimated with that weight. So, all right, let's hit this for, we're going to hit this for 4. Yeah.
All right, we're gonna hit 3 reps, 215. All right, 225 for two. Feeling good so far, so let's see how 225 feels. Also, this bar weighs 40 pounds, so that's why I'm adding 2.5 on each side, because if I didn't, it'd be 220. So 225, we'll hit this for two. All right, next one we're hitting is gonna be 250. This is gonna be for one. It's my last warm up, and then we'll see how I feel after that. I'm definitely throw 275 on after I hit this for one, but pay attention how it moves. It moves pretty fast. Of course, we're going up, and I didn't really struggle. We're going up. And then after I hit this, we'll rest 3 minutes. Those donuts look good? Okay, we're gonna hit our first one rep. Going for our one rep max. This is 275. I know I could hit this. 250 felt really easy. Feeling really good right now. Just really focused on being nice and tight at the bottom. Focus on a strong brace, three-dimensional brace, and keeping the lats tight. So about to hit this for 275 for one rep. Let's get it going. All right, 275 was a little bit more heavier load for sure. Felt it a little bit more. So obviously I went up in weight. I'm too close to 300. So we're gonna go for 300 here for one. And I'm gonna do the best I can just to move this thing as fast as I can on the way up on the concentric phase. Focus on a strong brace. I got a minute 10 and then I'm about to hit this. But yeah, I'm just looking for something that I need to strengthen and bring up more. It's going to be definitely more posterior chain wise, but just focus on strong brace at the bottom. That's why I'm not using a belt, and I like getting deep in my squat, so it's going to make it a little bit harder. If I bet you if I was going parallel, definitely hit a lot more. 300 pounds here. This is I hit 315 a while ago, but I've been working a lot more at mobility and feeling a lot better, so I just want to make sure that I feel good getting this off. It's gonna be a little struggle, I already know it. Just gotta be strong with that brace. That's like one thing I'm working on more. We are definitely done. I hit 300 pounds, happy about that. Wanted to just get out of the 200s. Felt heavy, but felt good moving it. You'll see in the video. I definitely knew that if I went up a little bit more, I was gonna struggle a lot more. So I'm gonna say 300 right now, just play it safe. I'm happy with that because I got pretty damn deep and I didn't fall forward, which is very happy, but I know what range I got to work on. I got to work on my mid-range, so more posterior chain that works that mid-range of the squat, and that's something we could talk about more. If you want to know more, comment below. Even if you want to send in your squat in the comments, I'd be more than happy to break it down and show you, hey, this is what you got to work on. This is what I see. These are things that you could do to get your squat better. I see it all the time, and I get clients' squats a lot better. You'll see, again, you see two of my clients, Marcus and Derek, beautiful squats. Very happy about that. But yeah, I just want to test myself today, and yeah, at like 178 pounds, being able to squat 300 pounds, getting pretty low too. It was very happy about that. Yeah, of course I want more, but getting the depth that I'm able to get during a squat, I got to keep that consistent. Got to be true to myself. So I know getting that low with 300 pounds on my back is takes a lot of work, a lot of effort, and yeah, I'm just again very happy about that. Hope you did enjoy the video. Something a little bit different right here. Yeah, ask some questions. Appreciate you, and look forward to the next one.